So I decided to come to Walmart to rent a couple Redbox movies, and I checked the figure section, and look what I frickin' just found. And... holy ass! What's going on, everyone? Happy Valentine's Day! I just freaking scored big time at my Walmart that usually never has jack squat. I went in here to get some Redbox movies because it is Tuesday. Which movies did I get? I got Arrival, which I saw in the theater, which was a really, really good sci-fi movie. I got The Girl on the Train, which Mrs. Cincy read the book, so I think she's going to want to watch that one. And then I got Keeping Up with the Joneses, which I may have gotten twice, because I don't remember if I already got this or not. So hopefully I didn't already rent it. I also came here to get some flowers from my mom, because long story short, she fell. She's 73 years old. The other night she was trying to get up to go to the restroom in the middle of the night, and she like just collapsed. And she hit her head on her damn nightstand. Which has like a marble top. So she called, I was actually in Columbus when this all happened. She called Mrs. Cincy, and Mrs. Cincy went and got the girls to school, went and picked my mom up, literally picked her up off the floor. She was still on the damn floor. Carried her to the car, took her to the urgent care. Urgent care said, you better go to the ER because she might have had a stroke. So Mrs. Cincy took her to the ER. My wife is a frickin' super wife, by the way. Mrs. Cincy is awesome. She did all of that for my mom while I was away. So very, very forever grateful for Mrs. Cincy for doing all this for my mom. They ran blood work, did a CT scan. They did a X-ray. No broken bones. She's not concussed, thank God, for frickin' face butting the damn nightstand. And I can laugh about this now because we know now that she is fine. Based on the test, she's okay. Basically what happened is she got the flu, believe it or not, and she didn't eat or drink anything. She was malnourished, didn't drink water, like a knucklehead, and she freaking collapsed from the flu. When you're old, you have to keep up your food and your water when you're sick or you're not gonna get better. So yeah, she collapsed. Couldn't move her legs, face planted on the damn nightstand, and she's okay now. No cuts, no stitches, nothing like that. She's getting IV fluids. As soon as they hooked up the IVs, apparently within like an hour, she had perked up. She was talking right again, wasn't mumbling. So yeah, that's the story. I got some flowers for my mom. Got her a little vase also. She really wanted to see Tay-Tay and P-Dog, but she's got the flu, so we can't bring the girls in there because we don't want them to get sick. So. I said long story short, but that was kind of long story long there. But yeah, so I scored big frickin' time. I wasn't even gonna look at the figure aisle because I was here like 2 days ago and they didn't have anything. I rented the movies, saw the flowers, got the vase. I'm like, you know what? I'm just gonna see what they got. And frickin' A! Look at that! Holy frickin' ass! Green Goblin. Very, very happy to pick that one up. I never noticed that that Sandman head is missing a freaking eye. That is awesome. It kind of reminds me of like the T-1000 from Terminator where he has that big hole in his eye after getting shot in the face. So very, very happy to pick up Green Goblin. That was the one that I kind of wanted the most. I got the 2099, which looks freaking awesome. This dude looks awesome. It's no wonder that this is so sought after. But He's badass. And then I got also the UK Spidey because it was the only one that they had on the shelf. They had a couple of black suit Spideys. They had a couple of, what's that dude's name? Jackal. But I got UK Spidey because he was the last one on the shelf. So I think I got a package from Nate Simmons, which I'm going to unbox from the Nerd Bar. And I think he sent me two more figures from this wave. So Nate the Great, you are the frickin' man. Thank you for sending me. I think he sent me Black Suit Spidey and Jackal. So if that's true, when I open that box, if that's true, I'm only one figure away from completing the Sandman. I'm the Shocker away. All I need is the Shocker. AKA one in the pink, two in the stink. I was not gonna say that joke because it's kinda bad, but I couldn't resist. I'm sorry. I'm sorry! I had to do it! That's the Shocker! I might stop at Walgreens after the hospital. I'm gonna go drop these flowers off with my mom. I'm gonna give her phone charger so she can text everyone. Because she's been wanting to text people. My brother and everyone. So I'm gonna drop these flowers off and then I'm gonna stop at Walgreens on the way back before I head back home and see if they got any of the frickin'... What am I looking for? The Guardians Wave. Guardians Wave! You guys in California, frickin' A! On Facebook, I posted that I'm gonna move to California because you get stuff like frickin' 2 months before we get it anywhere else. It's insane, especially Southern Cal. I wouldn't mind moving to California, to be honest with you. I don't know if Mrs. Cincy's okay with that, though. Her entire family's in Ohio, so I don't know if that's going to work. Maybe we'll be like snowbirds or something and go there during the winter. But yeah, you guys are finding the frickin' F out of that damn Guardians wave, and I need some of those figures. I really want that Star-Lord, Yondu, and Angela. The Angela looks damn good. So yeah, that's the plan. That's the rundown. Going to the hospital, visiting my mom, and then I might head to a Walgreens after that. But if I do, I will certainly show you what they got. So I'll see you guys soon. Thanks for joining me, and I'll see ya in a bit. Bye! All right, so I'm all done at the hospital. Just visited my mom. She's, her spirits are up. She's doing, okay. She still can't stand up, though. Doesn't have the strength for that. I guess the flu freaking knocked the crap out of her. So she's got physical therapists that are helping her to stand up and walk. But the doctor said that it looks like if she progresses as he thinks that she should, she'll be released tomorrow. So that's good news. Holy crap, I just chugged a Diet Pepsi. but she's doing pretty good. So glad to see that. She loved the flowers. I ordered her some lunch while I was up there. She liked that. So I'm actually not going to go to Walgreens right now. I'm actually going to go to Target, which is right across the street from the hospital here. So I'm going to hit Target, see if they got anything, see if they got the Guardians wave. Really want that Star-Lord. I think the Star-Lord's the one that I want the most out of that entire wave. Star-Lord, Yondu, and Angela. But that Star-Lord... I keep seeing pictures of that, and it looks really good. So, hopefully they got that one. If not, I'll check out what they got, and we'll see you there.
Hours later.
Decided to stop at a Walgreens and I'm looking for the new Guardians wave, but they don't have them. Let me show you what they got. So yeah, I decided to hit a couple Walgreens, and that was my first one. I'm only gonna hit two Walgreens. I'm really looking for that Guardians wave. But they had a couple of the new deluxe Transformers there. That was the first time that I had seen those. So they had Getaway, or what's the name they're giving him? Breakaway. He's based on the G1 character Getaway from the comic books though. And then they had Quake, which is also a G1 comic book character. Not really too pressed to get those two. They look pretty good, but I'm sticking to the ones that were kind of in the cartoon. I know there's a lot of bots that were in the comic books that didn't make it to the cartoon. A lot of Power Masters and Target Masters, but not really that interested in those. I might eventually pick those up, but they're not a top priority for me. So I'm going to hit this other Walgreens and see what they got. Hopefully they got something good, but I will see you guys there. So I stopped at Starbucks and got a coffee. Holy Cass! Garo Latte is what I got. The one they say tastes like cherries, but it doesn't really taste like cherries. It is very, very freaking smooth though, I'll say that. It's like the smoothest coffee I've ever had from them. It tastes like you're drinking a freaking heavenly cloud of awesomeness and freaking fairy dust. So I'm headed to the second Walgreens right now. Damn, that is a big ass school. I wish I could show you how big this friggin' school is. It's like a little preschool. I can't say little. It's friggin' ginormous. What's a good comparison? What's the biggest building you've ever seen before? It's like that big. But it's a preschool. I don't understand why you need a preschool that big. It's like a preschool for giants. Anyway, I'm making myself laugh. You guys are probably not laughing at me right now. I'm going to go to Walgreens. I'm going to see what they got. Hopefully it's not dry as F there. And maybe I'll buy something. How about that? But that's what I'm doing right now. I'll see you guys there. All right, we are at Walgreens. Let's see what they got.
I'm just a sucker for pain. I'm a sucker for pain. I got the squad tatted on me from my neck to my ankles. I'm pushing from the man, got us all in rebellion. We gon' go to war, yeah, without failure. Do it for the fam, dawg, 10 toes down, dawg. Love and the loyalty, that's what we stand for. Alienated by society. All this pressure give me anxiety.
Yeah, all done at that Walgreens. Nothing in there. Whole bunch of weak-ass weakness in there. I'm surprised that they still have a few figures from the Ultimate Green Goblin wave. Good freaking lord. When did that come out? Like 4 years ago? Black Cat. I'm surprised they still have her. You'd think that she would be gone by now. And then they had Electro, of course, because everyone hates that figure. And they had... what's his face? Ultimate Beetle? Was that his name? I'm drawing a blank. So in the comments below, if you know the name of that dude, Ultimate Beetle. That's what's coming to my mind right now. Post below what his actual name is. But he was in that Ultimate Green Goblin wave. He's the silver dude with the red highlights. I'm headed to Target right now. I'm gonna try and find something out there. So I'm headed to Target right now. That's my last stop. Maybe I'll stop at Walmart too, depending on what I find at Target. One of those two stores will be my last stop. But hopefully I find something good at Target. You guys have been finding some Guardians wave at Target. So I'll see you guys there. Hopefully we'll find something good there. Guess who just went frickin' ham at Target on some frickin' Voltron figs? So this just happened. Bam! Blue Lion. Got the Yellow Lion. Red. Green. So I passed on the Black Lion a couple times, but I kind of wanted to buy them this way. I wanted to buy all the limbs first before the Black Lion. A, because these are harder to find than the Black Lion. And B, because I'm a cheesy bastard and I want to do it the same way they do it in the cartoon. They had to find all the limbs before they found the Black Lion or unlocked the Black Lion. I actually meant to buy the Blue Lion first. I wanted to get them in the order that they were in the cartoon. Again, because I'm a cheesy bastard and I want to do it that way. It's just more fun for me that way to kind of mimic what they did in the cartoon. So, got all the limbs. I'm freaking happy. I am freaking happy. Didn't see a damn sign of any Marvel Legends, any new Marvel Legends at least. But I'm happy. I got all of my limbs. Now I'm going to start my quest for the Black Lion. Probably not today, because I just dropped $80 on Voltron limbs. So I'll probably find the Black Lion a little bit later. Hopefully he doesn't become scarce and then I feel stupid for doing it this way. So yeah, I'm all done for the day. That's the end of the hunt. Probably the end of the hunt for a few days now because I spent some dough in there. But I'm gonna head home. I'm gonna show you the Marvel Legends that I picked up. I'm gonna show you an unboxing from Nate the Great. Got a box from Nate Simmons. And I'll see you guys at the Nerd Bar. What's going on, everyone? So I am coming to you not from the Nerd Bar. I'm actually coming to you from my mom's condo. So she had scheduled to get cable installed here. And obviously she can't be here to get the cable installed because she's in the hospital still. She is progressing nicely, by the way, but they said that she might be actually going to a rehab center for her walking and standing and whatnot. And she might be there for up to like a week or more. So I am here at her condo to get her cable installed. And while I'm here, since the frickin' message said that it was gonna take up to 5 frickin' hours to install cable, she's got one TV here. One TV, and that's all she's getting, just cable. She's not getting internet, no phone line. Why the heck would it take 5 frickin' hours to install cable on one television? I'm hoping it doesn't take 5 hours, but I figured that I would pack a bunch of crap and take it with me just in case it does take 5 hours. So I decided to do a haul and a little mini review on this guy while I'm here. So first things first, I got this Prometheus Engineer from NECA. I got this from Amazon. I think I got it for like $12 with Prime. So it was a heck of a deal. He does not come with any accessories. This is all you get out of package. But look at the sculpting on this guy. The sculpting is fantastic. Look at the detail that they took on this figure. I could not pass this up for $12. I really liked Prometheus. I thought it was a good movie, and I really was intrigued by the Engineer character. I hope they actually show us more about the Engineer in Alien Covenant. I doubt it, though. I think that they're transitioning back to like an Alien-type franchise as opposed to the spin-off on these Engineers. So I hope that's not all we get on these Engineers. There's still a lot of mystery to these guys, and I want to know more. But Prometheus was a cool movie, and I like this figure. I find it funny that it looks like he's wearing, like, buttless chaps. But he's a cool figure. He's going to look good in my NECA collection, and I'm glad to have him. So he is a tall figure, too. Look at how tall he is. So getting onto the haul. Again, I stopped at Walmart to get some Redbox movies and get my mom some flowers, and I was so surprised to find these guys here, but I got the Spider-Man 2099. Very, very cool looking figure. I got the UK Spidey, which, you know, he's not my favorite Spider-Man, but I collect Spider-Men, Spider-Mans. I collect Spider-People, so I had to have him. Any kind of Spider-Man that they make, Spider-Woman, Spider-Girl, I'm gonna have them in my collection. And then I got Gobby, Green Goblin, arguably Spider-Man's biggest enemy. Can't wait to build this Sandman. I still need the Shocker and possibly the Jackal and the Black Suit Spidey. But I have a package here, which another air mattress from Nate, the Great Simmons. He sent me another air mattress, which may or may not contain the Black Suit Spidey and the Jackal. So I'm gonna open these guys up. But first, I wanna show you the other things that I picked up. Got the Voltron lines finally. Got the green, the red, blue, and yellow. I have been thinking about picking these up since I first saw them on the shelves. I passed on them a couple times and then they became scarce really fast. So I'm looking forward to these. I talked to T-Man about it. He had all of these Voltrons, but he said that there's no head articulation. And that kind of scares me, so I don't know. But it's still, they still look really cool. The lines look really cool. I'm loving the cartoon series. I'm still on season one though. I have not made it past season one. I need to catch up, but I think they look really cool. All right, so that leaves us with this unboxing. Again, Nate Simmons, thank you very, very, very much, sir, for sending this to me. I'm not 100% sure of what's in here. He kind of hinted that there might be a Black Suit Spider-Man and a Jackal in here, and if there are, I will be absolutely ecstatic because I'll be one figure away from completing that Sandman. I'll only be a Shocker away. So, brought my knife. Let me go and open this sucker up and see what's in here. All right, so we got, whoa. All right, so two items in here. Nate packaged these up really, really well. There's bubble wrap, there's all kinds of packaging in there. So thank you very, very much, Nate, for taking so much time to package these things up. And again, thank you for just sending these to me. That was awesome. I really, really appreciate it. So let's see what's in here. All right, so the first item is... Ha-ha! Yes! Look at this dude. It is Jackal. Let me show you guys, and then I'm going to admire this badass. Very, very cool looking figure. That's awesome. Thank you so much, dude, for sending this to me. Jackal. Question for those that are currently reading Amazing Spider-Man. The clone conspiracy. The bad guy in that series, I think, is Jackal. Is that the same guy, or is it a different Jackal? Because they look totally different. The guy in the Clone Conspiracy comic book is like, he looks like just a regular dude with a mask on. He doesn't look like this. So I'm not sure if it's the same Jackal or not, but if you're up on your comic book reading, you read Amazing Spider-Man, let me know in the comments if it's the same dude. But he looks freaking awesome. Such a cool figure. I love these Spider-Man Marvel Legends. All right, so let me open the second one here. All right, and the second one we got is, yes! Oh, yes. It is the Black Suit Spider-Man. So originally they made a Black Suit Spider-Man figure in, I think it was the Red Hulk wave a long, long time ago. What was that, like 8, 9, 10 years ago? It was a Target exclusive wave. And the figure that I wanted the most out of that wave was the Black Suit Spider-Man. Because when I first started reading comics in the 80s, the Black Suit Spider-Man was, that was the Spider-Man. He had that costume. I started really, really getting into Spider-Man comics when Todd McFarlane started around Amazing Spider-Man 298. And then he went back to his red costume in issue, I think it was 301. The Black Suit Spider-Man means a lot to me. It's like a trip back to my childhood, and I've always wanted a Black Suit Spidey, and this looks freaking sweet. This looks like the Pizza Spidey sculpt, but just in the black suit. It looks so awesome. Thank you so much, dude. Thank you so much, Nate, for sending this to me. This and the Jackal, I'm one figure away from completing Sandman now. I'm a Shocker away. I wish I picked that Shocker up at Toys R Us that I saw. It was like a week or two ago. But I'll be looking for him. I know he's on Amazon for like $21. It'd be cool to find him in the wild, though. But yeah, one figure away from my Sandman. I'm really, really excited. Again, thank you so much, Nate, for sending these to me. But I have quite a freaking haul here. I can't wait to... My freaking hand is stuck in the box. It's seriously stuck in here. Ow, damn it. So yeah, that's it. That's it for this video. That's it for this haul. Coming to you live, not live, from my mom's condo. Staring at a ass load of awesomeness right now. Look at this. Look at this. All kinds of awesome. All kinds of awesome. We're the... Awesomeness everywhere. Awesome party. So yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing, and sharing. I definitely appreciate it. But as always, I'm having fun collecting. I want you to also have fun collecting. See you guys later, and I'll see you in the next vid. Adios, muchachos!
Turn down for what?